What's up, it's you? For today's video, we're being full Darkrai team. I'll be using six Darkrai, with six different move sets. Let's have a look at its stats. They're pretty good. Its special attack, especially, and its speed give it a very good chance of just destroying teams. Now, it gets a lot of curious and interesting moves as well, and I hope you enjoy the move sets that I'm going to show you. If you want your own custom theme team or Pokemon sweep, you can check it out at patreon.com/pimpmy tier 2 and above. I've got two battles today with the Darkrai team, and the first battle here, this is against Betta, and I just had this battle like just 5 minutes ago. So if this, my opponent actually does actually ever see this, so GG's. Our first Pokemon is going to be Sudowoodo, and I've got a Fling Darkrai. So we got Fling, Thief, Sword Dance, and Rock Smash. I got to try and make these Darkrai, I mean, it's a good Pokemon, so I'm good at making good Pokemon really bad, so I had to try my best to come up with six different strategies I thought could be interesting. Now this is, just looking on my spreadsheet here, we've got the Iron Ball Fling set. We got Thief, so you can steal the item afterwards and do a little bit of damage. You also got Sword Dance and Rock Smash as well for a bit of coverage. Now, Rock Smash has a 50% chance to drop the opponent's defense by one stage too, so you might be able to, do some good damage there. Unfortunately, the Sudowoodo is going to take me out with a couple of low kicks, and I had the Sturdy ability, but a solid performance there from Darkrai 1. Next Pokemon we're going to bring in here is going to be... Oh, look, it's another Darkrai. Now, this set is going to be a sub-punch set. I noticed it got a Psychic Punch, so I thought this could be pretty fun to use. Now, the EV spread on this one is going to be as follows. So we've got max attack and max speed Jolly Nature. So now that's going to be the end of the Sudowoodo. I'm just going to get rid of that. I had Shadow Claw on there as well for a bit of coverage against Ghost types. Hypnosis and Substitute. The thing about Darkrai, right, after it's like it's nerfed to Dark Void, Hypnosis is actually better than, actually using Dark Void. But I did include Dark Void on one of the sets. I mean, I had to have Dark Void at least on one of them. So this is pretty funny. So we got the Empoleon coming here, which is quite a good swap in. However, I do have Focus Punch, which obviously they're not aware of yet. So I'm going to be throwing the sub up here so I can go for sub punch, not take any damage. Empoleon wakes up right away and is going to hit me with a Hydro Pump. So I do not want to get hit by this move. That'll drop my Darkrai one shot. So I thought, well, I either go for Hypnosis and try the sub again, or I just, put the Empoleon to sleep, hopefully it doesn't miss, and then go for Focus Punch. The item on this is Leftovers as well, so it went rather well with Substitute. So putting the Empoleon to sleep again, and Bad Dreams is going to kick in. I'd tell you what one of my favorite Darkrai sets is, and it's got a move that's not in the game anymore. It was a Nightmare Bad Dreams combination with Dream Eater. That was like one of my favorite sets. I think I featured in one of my videos from Gen 7 or early, You'd have to be a real, avid Pipnight watcher or have a good memory to, know where that one actually cropped up. But that's one of the sets I really like to use. So I'm going to land that Focus Punch on the Apollo because it misses Hydro Pump. You wouldn't read about it, people. They had to be a little bit salty there. I would have been salty. Like, I'm being real about that. So that's the end of Sudowoodo. That's the end of a Penguin. Next Pokemon is going to be Luxray. Now, I'm not really sure why they called... Wait. Toyota is a type of brand of cars, right? I don't know why they're called Luxray Toyota. I'm not sure. A luxury Toyota? I'm not sure. I'm probably missing some like really obvious pun which you can roast me for in the comments. So go for a Focus Punch here. I've got to tighten that focus. And now we've got a special Luxray. So that's going to get hit by the Thunderbolt. They actually went for a Thunder Wave the first time, so I wasn't sure what moveset they were going to be. So if you got the option of being faster and you got Substitute, it's always a good idea to go for that, at least to see what the opponent is actually going to be. So go for Focus Punch there. Pretty good damage on Luxray. Luxray's got some pretty good bulk to too. And Darkrai's attack, well, it isn't the greatest in the world. Normally, it needs a little bit of support there from, Sword Dance or something like that. So go for Shadow Claw. Luxray's going to go for a Thunderbolt. And it doesn't do a lot, but it does paralyze me, which is a bit of a pain. So now Darkrai is going to be paralyzed. So I was like, well, I can probably go for Shadow Claw again. If I get a crit, I can maybe take it out. However, they're going to swap out the Luxray. It's gone back to the dealership. And in comes the Crobat. Like, okay. I just went for Shadow Claw here. Now, Crobat's a pretty good swap in because Focus Punch is going to be resisted. So I was kind of curious what Crobat was going to do. Like, was it going to go for U-turn or was it going to set up on me? I wasn't really sure. Now Crobat is going to go for double team. Like, oh, it's a scumbag Crobat, all right? I see that, I see that. So it's going to try and raise the evasion. Now I'm going to go for the Shadow Claw again. It's doing pretty you know, kind of bad damage to Crobat. Crobat's got some, you know, pretty good bulk about it. I'm actually lucky it doesn't have Black Sludge because it could be, you know, even worse. Now Crobat is going to go for yet another double team. So they're going to try and get as many, evasions as possible there, which could be a bit of a problem if I do miss. But I had a pretty good run of hitting this Crobat with Shadow Claws. I got all three of those in a row, so things are, you know, kind of nice there. So at this stage, I think Crobat's, they're probably deciding, well, I better start attacking, you know, with this Crobat because, you know, none of the moves are actually missing. Unfortunately for me there, the Paralyze does kick in and I didn't get another Shadow Claw off on the Crobat. Now, just in case they did go for another double team, I went for Focus Punch here, maybe in hopes that they would go for another double team and land it, but they decided to go for another Sludge Bomb. I guess they didn't want my Darkrai around anymore. So that's the end of that. Next Pokemon is going to be, it's another Darkrai. Now, this Darkrai set was a Swagger, Foul Play, Thunder Wave, and Disable set. I actually had a lot of success with this set, which is pretty cool. So since Crobat's already got good base attack anyway, I just went for Foul Play, and that was enough to take it out. But the whole premise of this set is to paralyze the opponent and then use Swagger. So you got Parafusion. Straight away, it's a, you know, good combination there. Then, obviously, you've boosted their attack with Swagger. So since Foul Play takes the, obviously, the stat from the opponent there, it's going to be pretty powerful. So now in comes the Gastrodon here. It's going to go for a Surf. And does pretty good damage to Darkrai here. Unfortunately, my very first Swagger miss. So now Darkrai is going to go for a Swagger again on Gastrodon. So, like, okay, this is good. Then I can go for Foul Play afterwards. It should do a lot of damage to Gastrodon. You know, it should be about a 2-hit KO. Now, Gastrodon is going to be confused, but it gets confused, right? It gets through the confusion, and it's a mix set with Earthquake and Surf. I'm like, oh, this is a disaster. So that's the end of my Darkrai. So very nice, a mixed Gastrodon. Next Pokemon I'm going to bring in. Oh, look, it's another Darkrai. Now, Darkrai, this set is, this is the Dream Eater Dark Void Carmine double team set. So I had a double team 1-2. So let's go for Dark Void here. Dark Void is very, very inaccurate. That's the only problem about it. So my first one is going to miss. And now the Gastrodon is still going to be confused, but it's going to be able to get an Earthquake off again. So this Swagger that I did earlier on is really, really starting to bite me in the backside. So unfortunately, Dark Void misses again, Dank Void. And now the Gastrodon is going to hit me yet with another Earthquake. So things have, things have just gone, woo, you know, downhill here. So I've got to get back into this game. So that's the end of four of my Darkrai. Now I've only got two left. So we're going to bring in Darkrai number 5. Because I'm staying alive. This is a nasty, this is the best set on my team. So I tried to, I obviously had to run a special attacking Darkrai. I had to have one Darkrai that was reasonable, unless I come across a team that was very, very powerful, which I certainly did. But I tried to give it a little bit of mean to it as well. So I gave it Nasty Plot and Dark Pulse, which is, you know, very standard, very good on Darkrai. And I gave it Focus Miss, and I gave it Endure with a Mickleberry. So if I come across any Pokemon that resisted my Dark move, like, say, a Fighting type or in another Dark or something like that, or a super effective, something that's super effective, probably like a normal type, I could go for a Mickleberry Focus Blast and get that extra, you know, one stage of accuracy there. Unfortunately, it's only last that turn and that's it. So it's a very, very poor item, but it's pretty fun to use. Unfortunately, Gastrodon is going to be able to live through all the scum, and that's going to take my... I've only got one more Darkrai left, so we're going to go into my last one, which is my shiny one. This is a good shine. Looks very nicely. Dark purple and the pink on its face. This is probably one of my favorite sets too on the physical one. We got Sword Dance, Sucker Punch, Drain Punch, and Hypnosis. So I went for a Drain Punch here. I did not want a chance going for a Sword Dance because I could get critted by Earthquake and stuff like that. So that's going to be the end of the Gastrodon. Now out comes Casper the Ghost, which is a Drifloon. So like, okay, well, I don't believe Drifloon can one-shot me. I've got the opportunity to either go for Hypnosis or go for Sword Dance. Let's go for Sword Dance. So going for the Sword Dance, I've only revealed Drain Punch so far, so I don't know what other moves that I've got. Now, the Drifblim is going to go for a Fly. I'm like, oh, it's a physical Drifblim. Very, very nice. Now I went for another Sword Dance. Like, well, I might as well go for that. There's nothing else I can do. Now I've got +4 in attack. Now, Drifblim's going to go for a Fly, but it misses. And then I went for a Sucker Punch here because I knew they go, obviously, for an attacking move. And that is the end of the Drifblim. Last Pokemon is going to be, the Toyota. The Toyota has rolled up again. I've actually never had a Toyota. The only type of random cars I've had is Mazda. So I went for a Disrespect Hypnosis here. I was actually trying to take them out with Bad Dreams. But then I thought for a second, if I try and troll too much, this thing might wake me up, go for a Paralyze from Thunder Wave, and I'm going to get paralyzed every single turn. Stuff like that happens to me. So we're going to give the old Toyota the scrap heap, and that is the end of the very first battle. Thank you to my opponent, Beta, if you ever do see this video. It was a fun fun battle and a cool team there. Hope you enjoy my different Darkrai sets. Let's get on to battle number two. This is against Jim, and this is a pretty interesting battle too. Jim had a very, very competitive team, so it's interesting to see how my mean Darkrai sets would actually fare. Now, I also got a Darkrai sweep, and it wasn't the special attacking one. If you want to see the Darkrai sweep, let me know in the comment section of the video. And it's actually been quite a while since I've done these six Pokemon teams. So if you enjoy them, let me know. So first Pokemon is going to be the old Wash, and I'm going to get Wash. So that's the end of my Darkrai in one shot with Hydro Pump. That was my Iron Ball set, so it wasn't probably going to do that much anyway. So bringing in my second Darkrai, this was the Swagger set. So I'm going to get hit by the Hydro Pump here. As you can see, it's doing a lot of damage. I have got investment on this one in health too. So I've got max health and max speed, I'm pretty sure. And so we got max health there so I could actually live a Hydro Pump. And now we've got the Swagger going. So the Rotom Washer, the washing machine is confused right now. It's, you know, you put your clothes in, but it's not spinning around. It's throwing them out. So going for Foul Play on the Rotom Washer. It does pretty good damage. I'm happy with that. Now, Rotom Wash actually hit itself in confusion, so I was very, very lucky to be able to take that out there. I only got off with one Hydro Pump, so that was very nice. And that's going to be the end of Rotom, so that's good. That's a very, very good Pokemon, Rotom Wash. Next Pokemon to come here is going to be Azelf. So I was like, okay, Azelf. Well, I can go for Foul Play here. That'll do a lot of damage. Azelf's not very bulky, and it's got a good attack to that too. Azelf is going to get it's going to get washed as well. So that's very, very, very fast KO. Next Pokemon's going to be Gyarados. Now, this is a very scary Pokemon, and of course, it's going to have Intimidate, which not really is going to matter really at all to me, or at least for this moveset. Now, they're going to swap out their Gyarados. They're going to bring it in Intimidate me, and now they're going to bring in Scissor. Now, this is the Pokemon that I was very, very worried about because, obviously, being a bug type, and it's quite bulky as well, and I wasn't running very competitive, hardly any competitive sets as well, so it'd be difficult to get around this thing, probably it's just a, Sword Dance Bullet Punch set with Technician. And I'm sure that it has, a bug-type move as well. So that's the end of my second Darkrai. So into my third one here, I had to try and take this thing out with my special one. So I thought, well, it is paralyzed, which is good. Let's see if I can get some flinches going here. So I went for the Dark Pulse. Good damage to Scissor, but it's very, very bulky still. And now it's going to go for a U-turn. I'm like, yep, that's going to one-shot me. So that is the end of Darkrai right there. Crit absolutely didn't matter. It's coming from a Scissor. So this is very bad. There's some very, very great counters here so far. And I've already lost half my team. Next Pokemon to come in is going to be Blissey. So most Darkrai would have been stopped by Blissey, but I've got the Focus Punch set. So I thought I might as well give this one a roll, right? So it might be going for a status move here. So I thought I might be able to get around Blissey if it does go for a T-Wave or try and set Stealth Rocks or Toxic, something like that. Actually, I don't even know if it gets Toxic in BDSC. Probably doesn't. So anyway, it's going to go for Ice Beam instead. It's like, okay, that's fair enough. Will this actually break the sub, though? That's kind of interesting if it does. And it did. It's like, oh, okay, that actually did a little bit more damage than I thought. So I've got leftovers on this, which is fine. I can either opt to go for Focus Punch again or try and put it to sleep. I decided to put it to sleep. So I thought, well, knowing my luck, Blissey will just keep going for Ice Beam over and over. And I was kind of curious whether it would be Natural Cure or not. So Blissey is fast asleep there, which is good. And now I'm going to get some more leftover recover, and the Blissey is going to be tormented by the Bad Dreams there. I really miss my Bad Dreams nightmare set. Regardless, we're going to go for a Focus Punch here. I'm going to tighten my focus. Hopefully, Blissey doesn't wake up, and it doesn't. It closes his eyes, which is very good. Now I'm going to go for a Focus Punch here on the Blissey. Now, Blissey obviously was running max health, max defense to be able to live that. That attack there, and it's good damage. I was very, very happy about that. I just didn't want to let it get softballed off or anything like that. So now Blissey is going to have leftovers as well, of course. That's the standard item that it always has. Now I was thinking to myself, I might be able to go for a substitute here. I could go for that. I actually, however, have to take out Blissey with another Focus Punch because I've got Shadow Claw as my other move, which won't affect Blissey. Now, in comes Gyarados here. Obviously, they're going to try and drop my attack, which really isn't all that good anyway. To start with, I went for Focus Punch here, and I'm actually sort of surprised they swapped their Blissey out there, but I guess they had a nice and good Pokemon to swap in there being Gyarados. Now, at this stage, I'm sort of at disadvantage because I could go for Shadow Claw here, but I might get set up on. Judging from their other movesets, they're running very standard sets, so I say this is just going to be a typical Dragon Dance Gyarados here. So I had to sort of think what I was going to do. Then they swapped the Gyarados out, so they're just using it for Intimidate at the moment. And now they're going to bring back in the Scissor. So Scissor had already sustained damage there. I guess they suspected, or they just dropped my attack and thought I might go for, Hypnosis again there. So Scissor's going to swap that in, and it's also going to have Leftovers too, which is a little bit of a problem. That's three Pokemon with Leftovers so far. Blissey, Scissor, and Gyarados. I guess my opponent's team, people. It's a full Leftovers team. Not really. So anyway, I go for a substitute here, and I thought, well, I want to see how much Focus Punch does. I know it's not going to do very much, but I don't have much to swap into a Scissor, you know. Once it goes U-turn, that's going to drop pretty much every Pokemon in my team. And it's also got Bullet Punch, through priority with Technician, so obviously it's a very, very good counter to this thing. Like, Bug Pokemon are, you know, very, very good against this. So I'm going to tighten my focus here. Scissor's obviously going to go for its Bullet Punch there. Really, with a Paralyze, I was only doing that to... I knew that I had a priority move, but... maybe it might help me out if the Scissor does get paralyzed and I'm able to take it out or something like that. So doing some extra damage with Focus Punch, which really wasn't all that, you know, great anyway. Leftovers are going to heal most of that up. Scissor, I'm just leaving this in so Scissor can, you know, take it out with either one of its moves being U-turn or, you know, Bullet Punch. So Darkrai actually got another turn here because the Scissor actually got paralyzed. I just went for Shadow Claws, going for a crit here. That's my best sort of chance. Scissor is going to be able to outspeed me or Bullet Punch. I wasn't really sure. I was actually sort of hoping it would stay in so I could actually take it out because I only had like a little bit of health here as well. I wasn't really sure at this stage if Scissor actually had Roost either, you know, because that's a definite good move that the Scissor can run to. And then it used Roost. Like, okay, that's a problem. I actually don't have a Pokemon on my team presently that can one-shot a Scissor. It's not like I've got an easy fire-type move or a really powerful special move there. And I can't set up on it either because it's got a powerful bug-type move that can one-shot my whole team. And even if I somehow do live, it's got Bullet Punch to outspeed all of my Pokemon. So I was in a very, very tough predicament now in a very, very solid counter. And also a Gyarados that can easily swap into all my physical sets and drop my attack over and over. So now the Scissor is going to go for a U-turn, obviously, and that's going to be the end of my Darkrai as expected. So I've got two more Darkrai left, and I've only taken out two Pokemon, so something really has to happen here. I have to really start hitting this these Pokemon hard with something. So in comes Gyarados. It's going to get some more Leftovers recovery, and I'm assuming that at this stage this was a Dragon, like a bulky Dragon Dance set. Now, we're going to bring in Darkrai here, and this is my physical set. And I thought, well, you know, what's Gyarados going to do? Waterfall? So I just went for a Sword Dance here. Gyarados is going to swap out here, and Blissey's going to come in. So I'm like, okay, well, that's fine. That's a free turn to set up. I went for Hypnosis anyway. I was thinking about going for Sword Dance or Hypnosis. I guess they maybe expected that I had that move, or just wanted to see what move I was actually going to do. Blissey actually lives on one health there due to the bad dreams. Now they're going to swap their Blissey out, and they're going to swap back to Gyarados to obviously drop my attack there and, you know, see what move I'm going to be using too. I didn't really want to use any others. I only wanted to use one special Darkrai anyway. Like, all the other sets were mostly physical when you think about it. Like, there was one special set, which was the Dream Eater one, but that required, like, a lot of setup, so that definitely wasn't, you know, powerful or anything like that. So now I'm going to go for Sword Dance. Like, let's see what it's going to do. I know that I can live one Waterfall here. I mean, I'm not going to live it very well, but let's see what the Gyarados is going to do. So, of course, it's going to go for a Dragon Dance. It's like, okay, fair enough. Dragon Dance, it's got a plus one in its speed and attack. I've got plus one in attack right there. Now I went for Sucker Punch. Sucker Punch did excellent damage to Gyarados. Gyarados is now going to go for a Waterfall here. And I actually lived on a 19 health. So, like, oh, that's really, really good. I actually expected it to take me out. So I'm assuming they're running a little bit more bulk on their Gyarados. So now they're going to swap their Gyarados out. I'm assuming they're expecting me to go for Sucker Punch again, which I did because I thought, well, I've got nothing to lose here. What's going to come in, Blissey or Scissor? I was very doubtful they'd swap their Scissor in too because Scissor was sort of like the backbone of their team. Once they lost that, they were probably going to have, like, you know, a lot of trouble, even though I only had two Pokemon left there. So Blissey's going to faint to the Bad Dreams, which is fine. It was already, you know, dead weight anyway after I landed that Focus Punch on it. And Gyarados is going to come in for another Intimidate, like Intimidate number 1,000. So this time I went for Hypnosis. I have to go for that and try and put this Gyarados to sleep. Now, I've got Shadow Claw. I don't believe Shadow Claw would have taken Gyarados out either. And, you know, they possibly just would have gone for Waterfall that turn, you know, or Dragonette. So Gyarados is sleeping, which is good because Bad Dreams is just going to get rid of that Leftovers, or a little bit more than that Leftovers recovery too. So now they're going to swap their Gyarados out, and they're going to bring in the Scissor again. So, like, okay, that's fine. I went for a Sword Dance here on the swap because I had to get some damage on this thing. So I knew they'd probably go for either Sucker Punch or U-Turn. At this stage, like, they're probably going to go for U-Turn, you know? Like, Bullet Punch I was on a lower man health. They were definitely going to go for Bullet Punch. So I went for the Sucker Punch here. Excellent damage. Almost took it out. It was so, so close. And then the Scissor got paralyzed. Like, okay, so I guess I thought that would take Scissor out. So maybe I'd got a low, like, damage roll there. But then they got a paralyzed. So I guess that sort of evened itself out. Now they're going to swap their Scissor out. Interesting enough, they had only a little bit of health, and they're going to swap their Gyarados in. They're in a fair bit of trouble now because, you know, their best Pokemon are asleep, and one is on, like, one health. So I went for Drain Punch there to try and take the Scissor out. However, Gyarados swapped in, and I'm going to take Gyarados out. That was really good. I got around that Gyarados very nicely there. If I didn't have Sucker Punch, I definitely wouldn't be able to get around that because of the Dragon Dance. Next Pokemon is going to be Garchomp. Now, right at this point, I was like, okay, I have to go for Sucker Punch here. I can't swap into my other Darkrai. I knew the Garchomp would live as well. It's got Natural Bulk and Rough Skin, and I knew that it'd go for Earthquake or Dragon Claw or one of those attacking moves. So that's the end of my Darkrai, but man, that was a really, really good effort with Physical Darkrai. This is like Leftovers as well. That's Leftovers on Blissey, Garchomp, Scissor, and Gyarados. I can't remember what the other items were on. We didn't get to see ourselves, so I don't know about Rotom Wash. I can't remember. So we got this Dream Eater Dark Void set. Obviously, I'll get outsped by Garchomp. 3 minutes of the battle left there. I tanked that Dragon Claw, like, very, very well. It's very impressive. So now I'm finally going to land Dark Void here, and Garchomp has gone into the void. I'm going to get some Bad Dreams damage here. Now, at this stage, they have no knowledge of what sort of Darkrai set I'm going to run, so I very much doubt they're going to freely swap their Scissor into this. I say they'll sack their Garchomp off. So I've got Dream Eater and I've got Calm Mind. I'm like, well, there's a bit of a problem here. If you can remember, this Scissor is paralyzed, so I won't be able to put it to sleep with Dark Void. So that's going to be the end of the Garchomp anyway. Get some help back from Dream Eater. And now all that's left is the Scissor versus the Darkrai. And I think we're very, very close to, I think we're about 2 minutes away. Unfortunately, Scissor's only got a bit of health. They got paralyzed again, going for the Bullet Punch. Now I'm going to start going for Double Team. Like, well, I'm going to see if I can win this by the timer. They do have Roost, though, so I'm not sure how much they're going to attack me or they just start spamming Roost here. So Scissor gets some more Leftovers recovery there. I just went for a second Double Team here. Now, this little section here, I actually cut out because we went right the way down to the timer, and then Scissor's going to go for a Roost here. Obviously, they're thinking, well, you know, the chance of me landing a move, probably kind of a lot lower than they were before. They're paralyzed as well, so they don't really have the greatest chance in the world of a landing attack. I mean, it's still decent, but you're still not, 100%. So going for a third Double Team here against the Scissor, and Scissor missed all of its moves there. I did do a bit of a cut here after the second Roost because Scissor went for U-turn, I think, another two or three times. And we got down to the very end of the battle here with the Darkrai and Scissor. I went for my final Double Team. I think this is my sixth Double Team. I managed to get all of them up, and that was the end of the battle there. But a very, very close battle there considering how competitive that team was. And I hope you enjoyed that one, and I'll catch you tomorrow for another video. Peace out, people.